I've been bothered by the amount of lateral runout that I measured in the case in those V blocks, and I decided that I wanted to check it further, and so to eliminate any problems caused by the V blocks, I put the bearing cups and the adjuster sleeves on these side bearings and put this differential case with the ring gear back into the differential housing. Now, I did not put in the pinion gear. It's right here. So this allows the ring gear to spin freely on its side bearings. And I've got a dial indicator hooked up right here. And I'm going to measure the runout on the back of the ring gear. Now, by measuring the runout on the back of the ring gear, we can see what effect the runout of the differential case had on the installation of the ring gear. And so we're at zero right here, which is the farthest wobble towards the passenger. Let's see, that would be towards the, yeah, the passenger side of the vehicle. But as I rotate it around, notice I get clear up to six, a little bit below zero, six. We've got more than double the amount of recommended runout, this wobble, side-to-side lateral runout that we should have. And that's a problem because we have to have the pinion gear mesh and have backlash, and backlash means clearance between one tooth and the next. And the problem we've got is the backlash specification is 5 to 7 thousandths of an inch, with 6 being preferred. And if we have a 7 thousandths wobble back and forth in the ring gear as it contacts the pinion gear, we're going to have a backlash variation that's most likely going to be more than the 2 thousandths backlash variation that's allowed on any gear set. And if you try to put it together with more than 2 thousandths of an inch backlash variation, and variation is that you have to measure the backlash on every single tooth and compare the highest one to the lowest one, and if it's more than 2 thousandths of an inch difference, it's bad. And that doesn't mean it won't drive down the road. Obviously this was driving down the road before, but what it does mean is that for reliability's sake and noise sake and vibration sake, this thing is going to probably make noise. And since it would be once per revolution, it would match tire speed, and it would probably be some sort of a wow, 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 wow type of noise coming out of here. We would have to set the backlash really loose in order to not bind any of the gears when they're at their tightest point. So this is a real concern, and if this was a more modern vehicle, I would recommend to the owner that he try to find another differential case. But I still need to talk to the owner and see what he wants to do. But I imagine differential cases for 63 Chevrolet Biscaynes are hard to come by, especially ones in good shape. But I may be wrong. I don't know. But this is a problem that is bringing this reassembly to a halt until I can discuss with the owner what options there are and what he would like to do. So this has been a demonstration of measuring the lateral runout on the back of the ring gear during the process of installation. You can also do this on disassembly, And you should do it on disassembly just to see where it's at, especially if you're going to reuse the ring gear. And then, as you may be able to see right here, there's a missing ring gear bolt. There's two missing ring gear bolts because, as we discussed yesterday, two of the bolts stretched. And that brings this project to a halt also until we can get some replacement bolts.